Then it's a tough 8-7 back again along with two Scott guests of Eugene and Mikey and Corey on Team Viewer. And we're in the second segment in which we're doing Family Feud for the PS1. Well, yo, manners.
Mikey's vagina.
Mikey.
What's that?
Miss?
Miss.
The only vagina you have to suck is
and
John Boehner's, Mikey.
And hail from Oregon. Give a big welcome to family number one.
Oh,
they're from Edmonton, and they describe themselves as adventurous, but mostly personable. Give it up for family number two. These two families will be going head-to-head on the Family Feud. Here is the host of our show, Louie.
I did not.
You did not on what?
I'm not gonna go there. Keep going, Ben.
Dawn. Something. You gotta have to say something funny.
We surveyed 100 people. Top 5 answers are up on the board. Here we go. Both families, ready?
Yeah.
Name a public place where women sometimes put on their makeup.
Bathroom.
Family number one. You never know what's going to be up there. Survey says.
Mikey. Number two.
Yes, indeed.
Mikey, chatbox.
Good answer, but there's one that can beat it.
I'm not going to go there.
Ah.
Your answer, family number two.
Bus stop. Well, that's a good public place.
All right. Let's see if it's on the board.
That was a good one.
Good answer, but it wasn't in our top 5.
Hey, man,
play or pass? What do you want to do? Family number one is going to play.
Right. How about a restaurant?
Another player. You need another answer. Name a public place where women sometimes put on their makeup. You never know what's going to
happen.
Number
one answer. Three, two, one.
Restaurant.
And I get a what?
Good answer. Number one. Another player, okay. Got an answer for us?
I'm not gonna go there.
Ah.
Name a public place where women sometimes put on
their makeup. Oh.
Name a public place. How about the library? No? Oh, I got one. How about the hospital? No?
Restaurant.
Number one. You know what?
Park.
I'm gonna say church.
Alright. It's on the board.
Forgive me, Father, I have a sin. I also applied to a nun who is sleeping with a bouncer.
Another player! We need another player.
Man. And that will come up there. It will be another blooper.
Name a public place where women sometimes put on their makeup.
We're going at the park.
Okay. Show me the answer.
Oh, it's not up there? Oh, how about school? Would that work?
Careful. Only one more strike. Next player, what's your guess? Name a public place where women sometimes put on their makeup. I want to see that answer. Good answer, but it wasn't in our top five. Okay, next thing. Another player, okay. Got an answer for us? Name a public place where women sometimes put on their makeup.
Airport.
Is it there? Let's see.
Oh, it's not up there.
Good answer, but it wasn't in our top five. Yes, family number one gets the points.
What was three?
What was the fourth?
Car, taxi.
And a wrap.
Work. Home. Department store counter!
Let's see how our families are doing after the first round.
Oh, yeah! Well, they... Well, I guess they have to try their makeup kit at Macy's. Well, how could we never thought of that?
It's time for round two.
I don't know. Let's lead.
I need two more players up here. Let's go. We surveyed 100 people. Top five answers are up on the board. Try to guess the most popular answer. You ready to do this? Name the kind of person who speaks at graduation ceremony.
Principal.
Family number one.
I need a professor, that's right.
Survey said.
Three-hour tour.
Jeez. No, I'm sorry. Family number one, you get a chance, now.
Yeah, that principal.
Family number two.
A politician?
What the?
Oh! What the hell?
Politician.
Right on.
Our top.
You have a politician.
Way to go.
Never mind.
Are you going to play a pass?
Barack Obama or Hillary Clinton.
Pass? All right, then.
I found a Victorian.
Next player, what's your guess?
Oh, man. How come we never thought about that?
I'm the kind of person who speaks at graduation ceremony.
Valedictorian.
Is it there? Show us!
Number two.
Exactly.
How about the principal?
Next player, let's go.
Hmm.
Name the kind of person who speaks at graduation ceremonies. Okay, show me the answer.
Right on.
Good answer. Good answer.
How about a teacher?
Another player. You need another answer.
How about a teacher?
Name the kind of person who speaks at graduation ceremony. I hope it's up there for you. Nice try, but no. Mike.
Mikey? Yeah, I hear you, but I'm not gonna go there.
Aww.
Yeah, you wish.
Or having fucked Bieber.
Are you two ashamed to admit that you fucked Dan?
Now,
but
I'm not gonna go there. Can we, let's just set this to game up.
Yeah, we'll set it too.
Let's just finish this game up, guys.
How about celebrity?
Not to be rude, guys, but I
want
to get
the
cycle out.
Is it there? Let's see.
You got me shoot.
I thought it would be there.
Are you kidding me? I thought celebrity was a good one because they had celebrities talking at graduation.
Next family. One more strike, and you get a chance to steal. Another player, okay. Got an answer for us?
No.
With Bieber.
Name the kind of person who speaks at graduation ceremony.
No, that was you sucking Bieber's balls.
Or fucking her vagina.
I'm drawing a blank.
Mikey fucking his own to JJ.
How about a student?
Yeah,
student.
Alright. Let's see. Because now I'm drawing a blank. I'm drawing a blank. I
good
can't
answer, but it wasn't in our top five.
Anything else.
Yeah.
Oh well.
It's your turn. Another player, okay. Got an answer for us? Name the kind of person who speaks at graduation ceremony.
School board.
Good answer. Yeah, good answer. Is it up there?
Always speak to Wahala's graduation.
Good answer, but it wasn't in our top five. Give family number one those points.
137. Five for mysteries. What was four?
Most popular answer. And to wrap things.
Clergyman. Businessman.
Brings us to the end of round two. Let's look at the scores. Well done, family number one. Okay, it's round three. Let's go. A member from each family. Let's go. We surveyed 100 people. Top four answers are on the board. Try to give the most popular answer.
Oh, shit.
You ready to do this? Name one specific indication that a baby isn't feeling well.
I'm crying.
Okay, family number one.
I thought it was the bribe question.
I hope it's up there for you.
And if it was...
Okay.
I was going to say, if it was, it's Deja Vu again.
You got it.
But it's not.
One answer.
It's in the case of not the baby, so we're going to play.
Family number one is going to play.
How about a fever?
Okay. Any answer for us?
How about a fever?
Name one specific indication that a baby isn't feeling well.
A fever, of course.
I hope it's up there for you.
Has fever.
Good answer. Good answer.
This again.
Another player, okay. Got an answer for us? Name one specific indication that a baby isn't feeling well.
How about a diaper rash?
Survey says... Another player, okay. Got an answer for us? Name one specific indication that a baby isn't feeling well.
Grumpy, I don't know.
Survey said.
Strike two.
Uh oh. That's strike number two.
Now we.
I'm not hungry.
One more strike and you're up, family number two. Next player, what's your guess?
Not. Oh, yeah, that's a good one.
Name one specific indication that a baby isn't feeling well. Okay, show me the answer.
Oh, well.
Good answer, but it wasn't in our top four. Next family, it's your turn. Next player, what's your guess? Name one specific indication that a baby isn't feeling
flushed.
Is it there? Let's see.
What the fuck is going on outside?
Vomiting would have worked.
Oh, puking. Yeah, how could we never thought?
Good answer.
Coughing?
But it's not on the board. Give family number one those points.
What was three?
And to complete the board.
Flushy. Crabby. Lit.
That takes us to the end of this round. Let's check the scoreboard.
What was number four?
Litless. Wait, you said grumpy. Wait, you said grumpy and they didn't accept. Well, we still got the lead.
In round four, points are triple, but you only get one strike. Then, the other family gets a chance to steal. Let's play. I need two more players up here. Let's go. Fifty people surveyed twice. That's 100 people. We got top four answers. You just gotta give them to us. Ready? Name something families do in a car on a long trip.
Wait.
Family number one.
Single first.
Is it there? Show us. sing.
Cool. You got it.
Okay.
Our number one answer.
Then we go to sleep.
Are you going to play or pass?
But not right now.
You're playing? Okay. Next player, what's your guess?
Sleep. Sleepy bye.
Name something families do in a car on a long trip. I hope it's a
family. Oh, that's gonna look on sleep. Well, it does, and it's number 11.
Yes,
good answer! Good answer!
How about play games?
Another player, okay. Got an answer for us? Name something families do in a car on long trips. Is it there? Let's see.
Oh, all right.
Play games number 2.
Good answer. Good answer.
Eating.
Another player. Okay. Got an answer for us?
I'll be right back. I gotta go plug in my Halloween lights. All
right. Name something families do in a car on long trips. Let's see if it's up there.
Nope. That's okay.
It's not up there. I gotta
if it's not up there on their end, we go to Fast Money. And I think I know number 3. If it's listen to the radio,
next time we get to another player. We need another answer.
Yeah, that's a lot.
Name something families do in a car on long trips.
Read maps. Nah.
Survey said.
We won.
Good answer, but it wasn't in our top 4. Yes, family number 1 gets the points.
All right, we won. What was 3?
Was in third place.
They fight?
That takes us to the end of this round. Let's check the scoreboard.
What is it, Jerry Springer?
What is Simpsons or Mountain in the Middle or any other dysfunctional family program?
The Middle.
Boy, what a game. Congratulations to both families. But going on to the Fast Money round is
now, who's
one.
Going second? And Chloe can help out.
It's the Fast Money round. I need 2 players.
Well, Chloe can help out, actually.
We'll get going.
Yeah.
Put that on me first. I can't even.
You can just call me on the cell phone when the turn comes up.
Alright.
5 questions. Good luck. The clock starts when I finish reading the first question.
You ready, Mike?
Yeah.
Name something you do that really tires you out.
Exercise.
Name a street named after a tree.
Palm.
Name something you see along the side of a street.
Houses.
Name something that's cold.
Number 4.
Name something that's what?
Name something that's cold.
Ice.
Uh-oh, dumb answer alert.
Name the most common age for wives to leave their husband.
Oh. Are you ready for this?
Yeah.
Name the most common age for wives to leave their husbands.
Ha ha ha!
You said palm.
Oh, wow.
That's okay.
Name something you see along the side of a street.
Houses, survey said.
Oh,
name something that's cold.
Ice. That's really cold. And that... 29.
Name the most common age for wives to leave their husbands.
69! That is zero!
No!
We have our second player. Same five questions. Try to give the most popular answers. If you don't know it, pass, and I'll get back to it if there's time. Good luck.
Are you also gonna get Corey in here for this too?
Yeah. Idiot, you and Eugene.
On land.
Alright. Then we also got Eugene with us.
Alright.
Combine both. Both of you need to get 100. What's it, we're at 88.
112.
112 together, so that's 66 each. Why can you call me?
Can I be the smart ass?
I'll tell you what. Well, in the last one, alright?
Don't forget, Mikey. Someone's got a trigger.
I know.
And he's really got his right finger on that. Okay, you guys ready?
Yeah.
Name something you do that really tires you out.
Work. Work, yeah, work.
Both have to really do this together, so you both have to agree on the answer.
Name a street named after a tree.
Oak.
Oak. Oak.
Oak. Oak. Oak. Oak. Oak will be better.
Name something you see along the side of a street.
What was that?
Name something you see along the side of a street.
A stop sign.
Yeah, stop sign.
Name something that's cold. Something that's cold.
Huh? Ice cream. Same thing as ice.
Name something that's cold. Popsicle.
Yeah, try popsicle.
Name the most common age for wives to leave their husbands.
40?
Yeah.
Mikey, go ahead and say...
65. Did it even make the survey?
No.
It didn't.
Thank God.
No, but you would have got that slice of a dead thing, dog.
Oh.
Alright, here we go.
Let's check it out and see how you did.
If we don't win, Chloe, you can send Mikey over the moon.
It really tires you out.
Look. Lavin. Exercise. Number one.
Name a street named after a tree.
Oak. 25. Number one.
Name something that's along the side of a street.
Stop signs, have we said? Only three. Fire hydrant tree.
Name something that's cold.
Popsicle, somebody said. Two. Eyes. Number one.
Name the most common age for wives to leave their husbands.
40. Only 26.
That's too bad. Nice try. You're still our number one family, though. Congratulations.
5 foot point is 775 plus 1,000. $1,775.
Thanks for joining us on the Family Feud. I hope you had a good time. So long, everybody.
I'll be right back, okay? Hang on.
So that's it for Family Feud for the PS1. Coming up next, Remy for the PC.